Hello everyone, welcome back to our YouTube channel Alisha Maths Classes. So today I am going to introduce exercise 10.3 of class 11th, chapter number 10, straight lines. So for the introduction part of this exercise, you can just see in the description box. The given description is given in the description box. To see the solution of any exercise 10.1 or 10.2, you can just see over there. And for the, if you want to see the introduction of the or the derivation of the formula to find out the distance of a point from a line, then you can get the link over the description in the I link. You can see over there to check that formula. So now we'll start from exercise question number 1 of this exercise 10.3. The question is, reduce the following equations into slope intercept form and find their slope and the y intercept. So we have done all the types of equations of line in the introduction part of this chapter. What are the various forms of equations like, that is slope form, slope intercept form, normal form. So we have discussed each and every part of that line. So if you have not watched that video, you can see in the description box. So from there we know that the slope intercept form of equation of line is y is equal to mx plus c. So please remember, the equation of line in slope intercept form is y is equal to mx plus c, where m is the slope of this line and c is the intercept with the y-axis. So that means if I have to change this equation into slope intercept form, then we have to change this equation in this form. So you just need to, what to do, you just need to take the y variable on the left hand side, and whatever is there you have to just take in the right hand side. So x is here positive, it will become negative. So y is equal to minus x by 7. Okay, so now slope intercept form is y is equal to mx plus c. If I will compare this equation by the given equation, I will get comparing 1 and 2. So I get, see here, x is the coefficient of x is here m, and the coefficient of x is here minus 1 by 7. So that means slope of this equation is minus 1 by 7. So this is very simple. And c is the intercept with the y-axis. Let me tell you what do you mean by the intercept. If any line cuts the x-axis and the y-axis, then y-intercept means when it will touch the y-axis, what is the distance from the origin, whatever the distance from the origin to the point where it cuts the y-axis, that is called the y-intercept. So here you can see that there is no constant here. So if I'll compare this by this, I'll get c is equal to 0. So that means slope of intercept with the y-axis is 0. Moving on to the second part, same here, you just need to write down the variable y on the left hand side, and remaining things you have to shift to the right hand side. So y will remain on the left hand side, and 6x becomes minus 6x, minus 5 becomes minus 5. Sorry, minus 5 becomes plus 5. So here I get minus 6x upon 3 plus 5 upon 3. I have shifted this 3 on the right hand side and it will come in the division. So finally it becomes minus 2x plus 5 by 3. So these questions are very, very simple. So comparing with the slope intercept form, slope intercept form, that is y is equal to mx plus c, I'll get m is equal to, here m is minus 2 and c is here 5 by 3. So this is the intercept with y-axis. Intercept with, you can write down, intercept with y-axis is 5 by 3, and this is the slope minus 2. Moving on to the next part, this is the most easiest of all, already given in the desired form, that is y is equal to mx plus c. So it can be written as 0 into x plus 0, comparing with slope intercept form, with slope intercept form, I'll get y is equal to mx plus c, y equal to mx plus c, I'll get m is equal to 0 and c is also 0. So that means slope is 0 and y intercept is also 0 in this case. So students, this is very simple question. Please note down. So students, next question is question number 2, that is we have to reduce the following equations into intercept form and find their intercept with the axis. Axis means that x-axis and y-axis, you have to find out the intercept with the x-axis and the y-axis, that means this distance and this distance. So first of all, you need to remember here what is the intercept form of equation of line. So let me remind you, the intercept form of equation of line is, we have done in the introduction part of various forms of equations of line, intercept form is x upon a plus y upon b is equal to 1, where a is the intercept with the x-axis and b is the intercept with the y-axis. So first of all, we have to convert all the given equations in this standard form, that is x upon a plus y upon b is equal to 1. So let us see one part and you will be able to understand all the parts, because we have to follow the similar steps for all the parts here. So the first step is that you have to take whatever the coefficient is there, you have to take the coefficient or the constant term on the left hand side. You have to take the constant term on the right hand side or separate. So minus 12 becomes plus 12. Now divide complete equation by, because you know that here on the left, on the right hand side we are having 1. To make it 1, we will divide complete equation by 12, because 12 divided by 12 will only make it 1. So divide equation by 12. So I get 3x upon 12 plus 2y upon 12 is equal to 12 upon 12. So it becomes x upon 4 plus y upon 6 is equal to 1. Now you have just seen here that it has been changed into the intercept form. So intercept with x-axis is, so I told you that A is the intercept with the x-axis. So A is equal to 4, that is intercept with the x-axis is 4. And similarly, the intercept with the y-axis is here 6. So this is very simple question, because first of all, we have to reduce the equation in this intercept form. We have already reduced here and we have to find the intercept also. We have found the intercept also by this method. Just compare and you get the intercept. The next second part, here you can observe that already the constant is there on the right hand side. The first part you don't need to do. So you'll just start from the next step, that is we have to make 1 on the right hand side. So to make this 1 on the right hand side, we will divide complete equation by 6. So dividing by 6, I will get 4x upon 6 minus 3y upon 6 is equal to 6 by 6. So you can cancel here, whatever can be cancelled. So here it can be 2 is there in the numerator. So if I'll change or I'll shift this 2 in the denominator, it becomes 3 by 2 minus y upon 2 is equal to 1. So please remember that whenever there is constant on the numerator, you have to shift in the denominator just to make this equation in the intercept form. So this is intercept form. And clearly you can see here that intercept with x-axis is 3 by 2 and intercept with y-axis is, listen to me, here I am having plus but here I am having minus. To make it in plus, I'll put here plus and here minus. So that means intercept with x-axis is 3 by 2 and intercept with y-axis is minus 2. So this is the part. Now moving on to third part, that is 3y plus 2 is equal to 0. Following the same steps, I will first of all shift this constant on the right hand side. I'll get 3y is equal to minus 2. Now to make 1 on the right hand side, we will divide complete equation by minus 2. So I get 3y upon minus 2 is equal to 1. So it can be written as there is no x here. So that means just change this equation into this form. So it can be written as x upon 0 plus y upon minus 3/2 is equal to 1. So here this is the intercept form of this equation of line, and clearly you can see that there is no intercept with the x-axis. So intercept with x-axis is 0 and intercept with y-axis in this case will be minus 3/2. Intercept with y-axis is here minus 3/2. So please note down. So students, let's see question number 3. Reduce the following equations into the normal form. Find their perpendicular distance from the origin and the angle between perpendicular and positive x-axis. So first of all, let us remind what is the normal form of equation of line. So for your understanding, I am just explaining again the normal form. Suppose this is any point P and this is the perpendicular distance from the origin P, and this perpendicular is making angle theta with the positive x-axis. Then normal form is x cos theta plus y sin theta equals to P. So this is the normal form, and we have understood each and everything in the introduction part of this chapter, where I have discussed that the equation of this line in the normal form is x cos theta plus y sin theta equals to P, where theta is the angle with the positive x-axis and the perpendicular, and P is the perpendicular distance of this line from the origin. So as you know that P is the perpendicular distance, and distance cannot be negative. So that means I have to change this equation into this form, and for that what steps we have to follow, let's see here. So the very first step is that you can see here P is there on the right hand side. P is perpendicular distance and distance is always constant. So that means you have to take constant on the other side always. But remember one thing here, that as distance is never ever negative, so you have to always make constant as positive. You can make x and y variable, the coefficient of x and y variable negative, but constant must remain positive. So for that, constant will remain here and x will move to the right hand side. Similarly, y will move to the right hand side. So that means I'll get equation x plus root 3y is equal to 8. So I hope that you understood why I have just make it positive, because perpendicular distance is always positive. Distance can never be negative. Now next step is that you have to compare this equation with the standard form. Comparing with ax plus by plus c is equal to 0, or ax plus by is equal to minus c. Here I just need to find out a and b. A is here, the coefficient of x is here minus 1, and b is here root 3. So what we need to do, mark this equation as 1, and we have to please remember this step. Whenever we have to change this equation into the normal form, we have to divide the given equation by square root of a square plus b square. So what is a? A is here minus 1. So minus 1 square becomes 1, and root 3 square becomes 3. So 1 plus 3 becomes 4, and the square root of 4 is 2. So that means we have to divide equation 1 by 2. So dividing by 2, I will get minus x upon 2 plus root 3 upon 2y is equal to 8 upon 2. This implies I will get minus half of x plus root 3 by 2y is equal to 4. Now comparing with normal form, that is x cos theta plus y sin theta is equal to P. So here you can see here that P is perpendicular distance. So P is equal to 4. So I have found out the perpendicular distance from the origin, and cos theta is here minus 1 by 2 because the coefficient of x is here cos theta and the coefficient of x is here minus 1 by 2 and sin theta is the coefficient of y. So here sin theta, that is coefficient of y, is root 3 by 2. So now we have to find out what is the value of theta satisfying both this equation. So first of all, you can see here that theta is sin theta is positive and cos theta is negative. So in all the quadrants, sin theta is positive, cos theta is negative. It happens in second quadrant. Whenever theta lies in second quadrant, then by the rule of after school to college, you have done this form in third chapter, after school to college rule, you know that in second quadrant sine theta and cosecant theta are positive and the rest trigonometric functions are negative. So here sine is positive and cos is negative, so therefore theta lies in second quadrant. So whenever theta lies in second quadrant, then theta is equal to pi minus alpha. Because whenever pi is 180 degree, whenever you will subtract any acute angle from the 180 degree, you will get angle which lies in second quadrant. So therefore theta is equal to pi minus alpha. What is alpha? Alpha is the angle which satisfies the value sin theta is equal to root 3 by 2 and cos theta is equal to 1 by 2. In 10th standard, you know that the value of sin theta is root 3 by 2 at 60 degree. Same, the value of cos theta is minus 1 by 2, that is alpha is here 60 degree. So alpha 60 degree can be written as pi by 3. 60 degree in radians can be written as pi by 3. So pi minus pi by 3 becomes 2 pi by 3. So that means the perpendicular is making an angle with the x-axis, that is 2 pi by 3. So normal form is, so we have find out the perpendicular distance and angle both. Now we have to just change this in normal form. So normal form is x cos theta. Theta is here 2 pi by 3 plus y sine theta. Theta is here 2 pi by 3. Is equal to P. P is here 4. So this is the required normal form. We have just changed this given equation into this form, and this is the normal form where the perpendicular distance from the origin is 4 units and the angle with the angle of the perpendicular from the positive x-axis is here 2 pi by 3. Just remember the concept of chapter number 3. Whenever angle lies in second quadrant, then theta is pi minus alpha. You have done in the polar form also in chapter number 5 when you have converted the complex number in polar form. So you have done this concept there also. So please note down. So student, next part of this question is y minus 2 is equal to 0. Here also we have to convert this equation into normal form. So the first step is that we have to make constant positive. So we have to shift it on the other side. The next step is that we have to divide the complete equation by a square plus b square. So a square is, as you can see here, that there is no x term here, so it can be written as 0 into x plus 1 into y is equal to 2. So here a is equal to 0 and b is equal to 1. You don't need to find out, or you don't need to divide it by under root of a square plus b square, because it becomes 1. If I'll divide it by 1, I'll get the same term. So there is no need to write down this. So just comparing with the normal form, that is x cos theta plus y sin theta is equal to p. So here cos theta is, what is the coefficient of x? That is 0. Cos theta is 0 and sin theta is here 1 and p is here 2. So that means perpendicular distance is 2. Now you, everybody knows that cos, the value of cos theta is 0 and sin theta is equal to 1 is that theta is equal to pi by 2 or 90 degree. We are having cos 90 is equal to 0 and sin 90 is equal to 1. So that means polar form is in this case is x cos 90 plus y sin 90 is equal to p. P is here 2. So this is our required normal form. Please note down. So students, next part is x minus y equals to 4. So comparing with the standard form, first of all, I'll get comparing with ax plus by. Ax plus by is equal to minus c. I'll get a is equal to 1 and b is equal to minus 1. So that means here I have to divide the complete equation by a square root of a square plus b square. So in this case a is 1, so a square becomes 1 and b square also becomes 1, that is root 2. So that means we have to divide equation 1 by root 2. I'll get dividing by root 2, so we get 1 by root 2x minus 1 by root 2y is equal to 4 by root 2. Okay, so now it becomes 1 by root 2x minus 1 by root 2y is equal to, if I'll cancel 4 by 2, see 4 can be written as 2 into 2 upon root 2, and 1 root 2 can be cancelled by root 2, so it becomes 2 root 2. Finally, now we have to compare this equation with the normal form, comparing with x cos theta plus y sin theta is equal to p. So here cos theta is 1 by root 2, cos theta is 1 by root 2 and sin theta is minus 1 by root 2, and p, that is perpendicular distance, is 2 root 2. So perpendicular distance we have find out. Now we just need to find out the value of theta here. So here we can see that sin theta is negative. Sin theta is negative and cos theta is positive. So it happens in fourth quadrant by the rule, after school to college rule. You know that in fourth quadrant cos theta and secant theta is positive and the rest angles are negative. So from here we conclude that theta lies in fourth quadrant, and in fourth quadrant we know that angle is less than 360 but greater than 270. So therefore theta is equal to 360 degree minus alpha. Now you need to find out what is alpha. Alpha is the angle at which cos theta is equal to 1 by root 2 and sin theta is equal to 1 by root 2. So you have done in 10th standard, the value of cos theta is equal to 1 by root 2 and sin theta is equal to 1 by root 2 at 45 degree. Sin 45 value is also 1 by root 2, cos 45 is also 1 by root 2. So we divide minus 360 minus alpha, that is 360 minus 45. So theta is here 315 degree. So this is the angle which the perpendicular makes with the positive x-axis. So therefore normal form in this case will be, normal form of equation is x cos theta is here 315 degree plus y sine 315 degree is equal to p, that is 2 root 2. So this is your required normal form. Please note down. So student, this is our question number 4. Find the distance of the point minus 1 comma 1 from the line, this line. So we have done this in our previous video. We have discussed about the formula to find out the distance of the point from the line. So if you have not seen, you can just see in the description box, in the I link given there, link is given there. So see, I am just reminding you, whenever the point PX1Y1 is given and we have to find out the perpendicular distance, so the formula is AX1 plus BY1 plus C upon square root of A square plus B square, where capital A and capital B are the coefficient of X and Y from the given equation, and x1, y1 are the points from where we have to find out the distance. So let's see here. First of all, we have to convert this given equation of line in the standard form. So just open this. This becomes 12x plus 72 is equal to 5y minus 10. So changing this equation in the standard form, we'll get this equation. 12x minus 5y plus 82 is equal to 0. So perpendicular distance of line of line 1 from point, the given point in this case is minus 1 comma 1. So perpendicular distance is given by, just replace x by minus 1, just put x by, the value of x is equal to minus 1 because the formula is ax1. So whatever the coefficient of x, it will remain same, and in place of x we'll put x1. So in place of x I am putting x1 is equal to minus 1. Similarly in place of y I am putting y1 is equal to 1 plus 82 upon square root of a square plus b square, where a is the coefficient of x, and you can just write down here a is 12, b is here minus 5, and c is here 82. So divide by a square, that is 12 square plus minus 5 square. So it becomes minus 12 minus 5 plus 82 upon square root of, the square of 12 is 144 and the square root of 5 is 25. So it becomes 12 minus 12 minus 5 becomes minus 17, and 82 minus 17 becomes 65, and 144 plus 25 is root of 169, and you know that the square root of 169 is 13. If I'll divide 13 by 65, I get 5. And as we are taking this mod value, sometimes it may happen that it becomes negative. But as you know that perpendicular distance can never be negative. So I'll take the positive value. So please note down, the distance is 5 units. So students, next is question number 5. See, first of all, we have to understand the question very carefully, because only when you will understand the question, you will be able to know what is given and what we need to find out in this question. So the question is, find the points on the x-axis. So first of all, you know that the point on the x-axis, that means whenever any point lies on the x-axis, the y-coordinate is 0. It can be any point. So first of all, suppose here that let P x1 comma 0 be any point on x-axis. So see students, first of all you have to just think about, whenever any point lies on x-axis or y-axis, what is the type of that point. If it lies on x-axis, then y coordinate is 0, and if it lies on y-axis, then x coordinate is 0. Now this is the point, whose distance from the line this, and the distance of the line from this equation is 4 units. This is given 4 units. Now we have just seen the perpendicular distance formula from of a point from the line is ax1 plus by1 plus c upon square root of a square plus b square. And given equation of line in this case is x upon 3 plus y upon 4 equals to 1. You can change this equation in the standard form also by taking the LCM. LCM is going to be 12. So it becomes 12. 4x plus 3y is equal to 1. Or it can be written as 4x plus 3y minus 12 is equal to 0. Now the distance of point, first of all you can write down here a, the a is the coefficient of x, that is 4, b is the coefficient of y, that is 3, and c is here minus 12. So perpendicular distance from this point, the point is here x1 comma 0 is equal to 4 units. This is given in the question. So just put in place of x, you will put x1, that is 4x1 plus 3 into, in place of y, you will put y1, that is 0, minus 12 upon square root of, you can find, mention the formula in the exam, that this is the formula to find out the perpendicular distance of a point from the line, that is a square plus b square. So a is here 4 and b is here 3, and this perpendicular distance is equal to 4. So it becomes 4x1 minus 12 upon square of, 4 square is 16 and 3 square is 9, 16 plus 9 is 25, is equal to 4. So that means 4x1 minus 12 upon, the square root of 25 is 5, and this is equal to 4. Now if I will remove this mod value, then I will take two values, that is positive and negative. So 4x1 minus 12 upon 5 is equal to plus minus 4. So considering the positive and negative values, I'll get two values. One time I am taking 4x1 minus 12 upon 5 equals to plus 4, and one time 4x1 minus 12 upon 5 is equal to minus 4. Now what you need to do, just find out the value from here. So 5 into 4 becomes 20. So 4x1 is equal to 20. 12 will become here positive. So 20 plus 12 becomes 32. So x1 is equal to 8. And in this case, 4x1 minus 12 is equal to minus 20. So 4x1 is equal to minus 20 plus 12, that is minus 8. So x1 is equal to minus 2. So here I get 2 points. So therefore, points on x-axis may be, points on x-axis is or are, because they are 2 points, either it can be 8, 0 or minus 2, 0. Both points will satisfy the given condition. Please note down. So students, today we have learned how to reduce any type of equation in the normal form, intercept form, slope intercept form, and rather than that, we have discussed two questions based upon finding the distance of a point from a line by using the formula, that is ax1 plus by1 plus c upon square root of a square plus b square. So I hope so that you have understood each and every question very carefully. So thank you so much for watching Alisha Maths Classes and liking my video. Thank you so much for all.